Hello, hello. It is another non-mailbag Monday mailbag opening. This time, it is, well, it's actually related to the last one that I did, which is that 3D pen. This is some the 3D printing filament that I ordered from Bot Feeder Canada. I ordered it 10 days ago, and here it is. That's the benefit of ordering it from within the country. And it wasn't actually all that expensive, but first, just take a quick peek inside here. It's a bunch of colors of 3D printing filament. Now then, I ordered both ABS and PLA. And I ordered one assortment pack of each. So I'm not sure how I ended up with three envelopes. Okay, well that's cool. Now then, how do I tell which one is ABS and which one is PLA? As somebody who has never had anything to do with 3D printing in the past. I guess the obvious first thing to do is take a look at the listing and see if it says anything there. So here's the first of the two orders that I placed. 1.75 millimeter PLA, 10 colors, 5 meters per color in the set. From Bot Feeder Canada, as we already knew, free shipping, $9.99 for that. So that's basically 50 meters of PLA and free shipping. And on the envelopes, I noticed that he paid shipping. What do we got here? Almost $10 worth of shipping across the two packages. So, that would seem to be a pretty good deal, all in all. So, that's the PLA. And this is the ABS. Again, 10 colors, 5 meters per color for $9.99 Canadian free shipping. I think I like this supplier. If I actually get into 3D printing, I don't have an actual 3D printer, but, you know, if I ever actually do get into it, I'm going to have to keep this guy bookmarked, I think. So now then, how is it that I got three packages if I only ordered two orders? So the colors in ABS, black, white, gray, silver, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, and in PLA, black, white, red, yellow, apple, green, jade, blue, sapphire, aqua, and chocolate. Okay. Now let's go back to the workbench and see if we can figure this out. This one looks like it's got more different colors in it. Let's see what's in here. Got green. That. Got black. Got looks like a red. Purpley, I guess. Let's get the. What do we got here? Is that a light green? And then a yellow and a white. Okay, so that's got all 10 colors in one. I'm just going to quickly peek back at my laptop here. Doesn't look like there's silver in this one. And the, which one was it here? The ABS had silver in it. So I'm going to guess that this one is the PLA. I'm just going to put this all. I don't see anything that looks like silver in there. Put those over there. You know, if something looks like it might be silver in these ones. Okay. I'm wondering if he split these up just for mailing costs or what. I'm not sure. I've read somewhere that PLA can be sensitive to humidity. And as my shop is in a basement, And as it rained this morning, I'm going to just re-ensconce these in their Ziploc bag. Okay, so I'm thinking that that's probably PLA. So let's see what we got in this one now, guessing that it's ABS. Yellow. Got this, which I think is a purpley kind of color. Oh yeah, you guys may remember that I am somewhat colorblind, so if you're screaming right now that that's not what that color is, you're probably right. There's that. There's a gray and a black there. I think that's gray. Yeah, there is a gray in the ABS and black. Okay. What's in this other bag here? Something that's either a blue or a purple, I guess. I'm not sure what the best way to store these. These are kind of sample sizes, I guess. An orange and a red and a white and a green. Okay, yeah. So this is most likely the ABS. Okay. I'm going to tuck these guys back in here. Again, fighting. I don't know if ABS, I don't think ABS is susceptible to humidity. I don't know. Not something I've come across in my reading. But I'm going to bag them up just to keep them together. And actually, this will become important later because they melt at different temperatures, or so I'm told. What color should I experiment with? Let's use the yellow since it's out. And I guess I'll start with ABS since it's out. I don't know. I'm making this up as I go along, because that's just normal around here. Okay, park those out of the way. Get this guy in here. So let's plug that in and plug in my adaptomatic over here. So right now, let's just zoom in here. Settings for ABS and PLA. I got ABS out, so we'll use ABS. Once it times out, okay, there we go. So it said it's going up to 210 degrees. Oh yeah, while it's warming up, let's go back to the computer for just a second. So ABS extrudes at 250 to 260 Celsius. And PLA extrudes at 200 to 220 Celsius. Okay, that's what I wanted off of there for now. Okay, so this is ABS, and it says it extrudes at 250 to 260. So I'm going to go up to about 250 on this pan. Oh, 235 is the top of the range. That's interesting. Okay. So, the other thing that I've seen people doing is putting down masking tape on this, on their print bed. Since I don't have a print bed, I just have a cutting mat. I'll do that, and apparently that makes it stay put while you're making your creation, and also makes it so that you can actually get it off later. It's not glued to your surface. Again, this is all experimentation for me. I am a complete and utter newbie at 3D printing anything, including using this 3D printing pen, of course. So, there's a workspace. That looks like it's up to temperature. Let's put that kind of over there. Stuff it in. Okay, so this thing back is faster and down is slower. Run them in, and it's actually going in. Ooh, and there I got some goo at the end. No! I pushed the eject button. Okay, so it ejects cleanly anyway. But that's not what I wanted to do. So I'll push her back in again. Till it starts gouging out the bottom. Okay. So let's just take a look. The first little bit that came out of here was some kind of a funky dark color. So that's presumably what was left over from the previous user. So let's go down to the slowest speed. Or almost the slowest speed. Let's draw a line. That looked like it was actually smoking. I'm going to turn this back down. Let's turn it down to about 200. And I'm going to slow that extrusion down a little bit more. Maybe that's what the darkening is. Maybe that's actually burning. So as the temperature's changing, it doesn't want to extrude. Okay. So I think I've got a... So the speed that I got set right now is... that, which is fairly fast. I'm going to slow it down some. Okay. So there's a shape. Let's just peel some of these out of the way here. It comes up fairly easily, but it sticks very well too. So that was probably a stupid thing to do. Okay. So now then, I'm going to... I don't know what I'm going to do here. Oh. That's fairly solid. Okay, and again, this is ABS. So I'm going to just try and do something without commentary here, noting where I'm actually in frame. That's interesting. It's already kind of cool to the touch. Just going to let it cool off a little bit more. And there we go. We'll pop it off. See what I've created. For somebody with zero artistic ability, and pretty much the first time trying, that's not bad. Okay, let's... I'm going to change filaments now, I think. So, push the eject button. And there it is ejecting out. Okay. So it kind of leaves a bit of a googly end at the end there. But that's okay. Nothing that that cuts fairly easily too. Okay. I'll put that aside. Push the button down there, so it's going to go for 200. Okay. So I'll let that preheat or cool down or do whatever it needs to do. And I'll get out to some PLA now. Maybe I'll try this white, just because it's the easiest one to get out of the bag. So, are we up to temperature? Maybe. So let's find the end of this. Put that up to high speed, poke that gun in there, let it feed. I don't have to feed it, but I kind of, just so I can see what's going on. Okay, so there is a bit of yellow left in the extruder tip. I'll run that out till it goes white. I'm wasting a certain amount of material. Okay. So there we go. There's the wasted material from color changing. That's not, I don't know. So this, this will have to check what that thickness of that is compared to the actual filament that goes in. Take that down to about half speed again. And I'll just do the same approximately thing. Make a little square crate-y thing. So that's interesting. That's at high speed. That's at full speed. And it's not pushing through. Maybe I was wrong about my materials. Let's turn this up. Okay, so let's draw. Okay, well that was interesting. Pull this stuff out. That's harder too. It's harder to cut. I'm wondering if I maybe got the material names wrong. I'm just gonna let that cool a little bit. It's taking longer. And let's see what. Yeah, that's staying flexible longer than this one. This one's quite rigid. While I'm waiting for that thing to cool off, let's just check. So that's 1.74 millimeters. It says 1.75, so that's, I'm going to call that close enough because this isn't a precision instrument. And the extruded filament is 0.89, call it 0.9 millimeters. So this is cooled down. I'll pry it up off the tape. That comes off reasonably well. Okay, so that one, yeah, it's fairly rigid too when I'm done. Okay. Interesting. What else can we see about these two materials? So I'm thinking I've got, first of all, I'm thinking I've got them wrong. I'm thinking that the white one is actually ABS and the yellow one is actually PLA. No, they're both fairly strong. The white one is a little bit harder to cut through with a knife. It's going to cut through some strands here. That's not too hard to do. Yeah, the white one's a lot harder to cut through. Huh, okay, that's interesting. So, that's as far as I'm going to go with this right now. I'm going to pass this on to my resident teenager who loves all things pink. And you would not believe how excited she was when she saw that I had one of these. Couldn't contain herself, and then she was pissed off at me that I didn't have any filament. So, I'm going to pass this off to her, let her practice with it a little bit, and then grab a bit of video for the outro. Think it's going to be fun?
Yeah.
That's good. So this is, other than some test pieces, that's pretty much your first, well, that cube, I guess, is your first real creation, isn't it?
The button's not working.
No?
It's like the pen's fine, but the button's just doesn't want to work.
Oh, you have to push it pretty hard?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, next time I have to tear it apart for cleaning, maybe we'll, Oh, yeah, I see. Maybe you'll fix that button up next time I tear it apart for cleaning.
Maybe.
But until then, you have fun with that, all right?
Yeah.
So, the verdict by my young artist is that it's a really cool thing and fun to play with, and that's pretty much her first project after just learning how to use it. So I'm pretty pleased. Well worth the, what was it? Less than $20. I probably spent more on filament than I did on the actual thing itself. Oh, right. Just got tapped on my shoulder, and she also made this little cube, which turned out pretty darn well, too, actually. This is actually an earlier experiment than this one. Moving parts. Ooh. Anyway, there it is. For those of you who mentioned that you hadn't seen one of these things before, that's what it can do. I'm sure with practice, the lines will get a little bit straighter and the creations get much more involved. But, okay, I'm just getting two thumbs up from over my shoulder here, so clearly it's a winner. Thanks for watching. Any comments or questions, down in the comments section down yonder. Talk to you later.